What's up, Scrolgers? It's Nerp here, and today I was going to record a ranked match video on my alt account, but a little post came up on scrolls.com which announced a pseudo ranking reset in a couple of days for the release. So this is not a complete reset like in the past, so it's not going to make everybody's rating zero. I didn't really understand the post that well. You can read AtMaz's post on scrolls.com, just go there. But from what I understood from it was there's going to be like some massive rating decay, so I guess everybody's ratings are going to come closer together and lower. So I think I'll still be like number one, but it's just going to be, everybody's going to be pushed down, so it's going to be hard for me to keep it. But yeah, so it's not really much of a point for me playing ranked right now, it's just going to get kind of reset. So at least this will be the first time I get an exclusive avatar head for my alt account. Yeah, the top 25 players get the same avatar head as last reset, which, I mean, I don't really care too much for because I already have it on my main account, but now I have a cool avatar head. My alt account, too. So that's not too bad. I used to hate ladder resets because I was always worried I couldn't make it back to number one on the top of the ladder. But I think it's safe to say that now I trust my abilities to do that. Because every time I was so worried whenever there's a patch or something that I won't be as good in the next meta. But really, I've been getting back towards the top every single time. So I'm not too worried. I'm fine with that. But what that means for today is I'm going to do a different kind of video. And I have OCD in scrolls that I have to be in General 1, not General 2. And I'm going to play some Ultimate Highlander. If you don't know what that is, it is a game mode where you have one of every scroll in the deck, so it's a 360 scroll deck right now. And then you duke it out with somebody, and it's a really luck-filled game, but it's a lot of fun. Yes, B4UX1T3, people play Highlander. So I'll be back when a match is found. Alright, we are in a match. So it looks like we both have a nice full set, and this should be fun. I'm gonna mulligan this hand, unless I top deck like a Brave or something like that. I mean, the memorial isn't too bad. He does not mulligan. It took him a long time to decide some mulligan, it looked like, so maybe that's not a great hand. And this is what I call a great hand. Halls is awesome, but it's going to take a long time to get there, so I'm just going to do the turn one Sinmark Zealot, my delayed spark. I can get a turn three Royal Skirmisher, this is going to be great, and then a shrine, a roasted bean potion. I could even put a Roast Bean Potion on a Copper Automaton, so I have a hasted 4 damage. That's going to be awesome. Alright, he is going for another resource. I could go for energy now. I probably would have done that if he played a creature. I would have just played the Copper Auto. I want to get to Wild as fast as possible. I'm getting a lot of order stuff right now. I don't really need the Tempo Theft, though. I'll get rid of that. And if he plays something with 2 health, I'll probably just sacrifice this dude to kill it. We'll see. This coming turn, I will play the Royal Skirmisher, I think. Right, he plays a Spark, so the Spark for the delayed Spark, I don't really mind that. You think I would want to keep the Roasted Bean Potion? I'm actually going to get rid of it. I think it's just going to be better if I just get some creatures on the board. So I'll just play him. And this coming turn, I can like play one of the one drops. If he plays something on the board, I'll probably hit the copper. If he doesn't, I'll probably just play the Shambler and a Shrine. So it's looking good. A Cannonetta. So I think I'm gonna go for the energy. I'm gonna play a Shrine up there and a copper here. So he can't. I mean, I couldn't spark anyways because. Yeah, he couldn't spark me anyways. because he already uses one spark in the deck. But yeah, my guys are pretty protected here. That Canada is likely dead, unless he has like a lot of health to put in front of it.
We'll see.
Okay, goes Pothers that away and plays Gun Auto. Okay, so that was a lucky Pother for him. Whatever. And I'm just going to play Mire Shambler. The 2 health Mire Shambler is awesome. So basically, this guy turns into a Ducal Skirmisher when there's a Shrine out. Yeah, so, I mean, still fine for me that what happened that turn, because I killed his 2-drop with my 1-drop. And I didn't take any damage from his Canada. Okay, he gets that, so now that Canada has 3 attack. A little bit more scary. Sacrifice Festering Fever Scrolls. Purification. Do I try to engage here? I'm not going to engage. I think I'll be okay staying away. I want to go into growth so I can go to wild faster, but I'm not sure if Illithorn Seed is going to be enough to pull me into growth, to be honest. I kind of wish I kept that Rose of Being Potion now, because I could easily take out that Canada. Okay, so he is building up some strong forces. Faith Chains. I'll get rid of the Illithorn Seed. And I get nothing. And I'm going to play nothing. Just move a little bit so I might have a better way to be able to move down. I'm going to need to top deck some kind of creature. At least he's not playing any more creatures now. Elnar Rod Eater, that's nice. So I'm going to go for some Decay. I could actually Grave Gruel. And Surge, I don't know. The Surge value would be 0, so actually Grave Gruel kind of sucks right here. I'm just going to go for straight for Decay. I want to get that Rod Eater out. I'm just going to stay where I am. I could Faith Chains, but it's really more Sacrifice Fodder. Yeah, Ultimate Highlander is not really a competitive format because it's very just draw dependent, but it's a lot of fun. You get to see lesser use scrolls just have big moments, so it's a lot of fun to play. And actually, I guess it is kind of competitive because there was a Highlander tournament for ESL that I won. You can find that on my channel. Solemn Giant is cool. Get rid of the Faith Chains. Alright, now I'm going to play the Rod Eater. And I'll just go like this. I don't really love my Skirmisher in the front row, but I don't really care. Maybe I should have just taken out that idol so I have Dominion activated, but nothing on my board would even use Dominion. So I'm actually almost giving up the middle idol. I hope I don't do that. Oh, he is going towards it, so that scares me a little bit. He has a lot of scrolls in hand, but not a lot of resources to do with it. Wildling is good. I'm going to get rid of the purification for growth now, and I'll start going into wild. And I don't know. I think I have to move both of these guys. I want to protect the shrine, I think. I could just play this. I have to move both of these guys down, I think. And then you can attack from anywhere. But do I just play this in front and then you can fly in? Then he has a clear shot on the shrine, which I don't want to happen. So I will go like this. So if he has any kind of attack buff, he can kill my Skirmisher, unfortunately. But then I'll have a little stronger Rod Eater at least. That's why this whole time was a little weird that I had my Skirmisher in the front row. I guess because he was like just protecting my Mire Shambler. Yeah, so this is just purely a 5 health wall. I mean, the chances he plays a lingering spell are not very high, and one damage on all the idols is not that important. I mean, who knows? Maybe it just activates Dominion for me, and then I draw something amazing next turn. So he is able to take him down. Oh, wow. That would have been a really great play if this guy died. But now, since he didn't die because he got the one health from the skirmisher dying, I'm able to take out a couple of his things. Or am I? How am I supposed to make this attack on this row? I can't play any of this stuff this turn. Besides Field of Strife. Do I sacrifice the scrolls and hope I top deck something that I can play so I get a 50% chance of this working? Screw it, I'm gonna do it. No, I didn't get it. I don't know what to do here. This is really bad. How do I do this for maximum, for like the best chance of this working? Right now it's a 1 in 3 chance. But then if it doesn't work, this guy's dead. I think I have to keep that guy alive. So let's go for just the 1/2 chance of killing that. Because I think I have to keep the Rot Eater alive. Come on, this row. Yes. Okay. Fortunately, that Ken Ned is still alive. I don't know how I'm going to kill that. So I went with a safe play there, but I didn't go for the big play. And this gives me energy. Let's just... let's just get rid of the budding retreat. You're going to be able to deal 1 damage to the thing behind it. So I do not want this Rot Eater within the area. Okay, I'll do it like this. So, at least I'm getting this guy up to 5 attack 2 health, and I'll have to move the Canada up. So I might have a clear shot of Kenneta if he decides to take down these units. Yeah, Kenneta has piercing, so that means take its damage, round it, take half of it, round it down, and it'll do that to the unit behind it as well. Sickening fumes. So this guy's only going to have 2 attack instead of 4 attack, which I guess sucks. I'm going to play the Wildling. I know this guy is not going to have, I mean, I may have been able to top deck something to kill this Dougal Skirmisher, but I think it's more important that I get a Wildling out. And I don't like putting all these things I can't move around here. But I guess I'll do it. Sure, whatever. I'll put him right in the middle. I don't like that spot. Whatever. He'll have to destroy my structure somehow. What's he gonna do? What is he going to do? He goes somewhere. He's a lot of resources. And the Wings Captain. Alright, that's good. And a Bakan, wow. And the Bakan has 4 attack, his Dominion. Fodder Pit. I can't play the Psalm Giant yet. Pillage, what do I pillage? Nothing. Let's get rid of the fodder pit for scrolls. Flip. Flippity flip 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 flip. Flip would be kind of useful. Yes, it would. But it wouldn't really be that useful. Because I can kill this Canada. So I'm just gonna move away with the Rod Eater so that it does not like die in case he has one a way to increase his damage by one. And I'll be able to flip something to the Rod Eater, which is good. And let's hope he doesn't have scary stuff. No scary stuff. No scary stuff. Royal Banner. That hurts because he is almost all human, wow. Ooh, State Machine. Interesting stuff. I think I'm gonna flip this. The Wings Captain, I can take that down. I'm actually killing you too, which is good. Unfortunately, I'll have to live with the Royal Banner though. Should I? I think I'm gonna want to keep the Psalm Giant over the Honorable General. I think I'll play the State Machine though. Let's get rid of the Honorable General for scrolls. Ooh, Kinfolk Brave. And I draw a soldier, and that's a really good scroll. I think we definitely want to flip right now though. So let's, and I'm also gonna play Brave this turn, I think. Yeah, it's a big turn for me. So let's flip this up top. Then let's play it's one a creature, right? Yeah. State Machine, then Brave. Okay, that was a big turn. Now I have two 1-countdown creatures. And they're humans, so the Royal Banner won't affect them. He is card advantage though, and he might have a slight resource advantage. Actually, resources were about even. Actually, I have a very slight resource advantage. Okay, I could get the Solemn Giant out and maybe end this game kind of quickly. That is an option. Oh, for a second I thought he had like a Mangonel speed. Hey, look, it's Nate Machine. Okay, so that guy has 4 countdown. Oh, a Jarl. Yeah, it's gonna take too long to get to the Jarl. I should probably just disregard that. I don't know, the chances I get something to kill this guy are so slim. I think I'm gonna Royal Inspiration right away. Wow, I drew some strong creatures. I'm gonna have 5 next turn. Scare the Jarl and go for more wild. And I'll play the Psalm Giant. So this turn, I guess I will. Go like that. And you go down to 4 health because the Shrine gave you 5 health anyways. So Shrine coming in handy. Maybe I shouldn't have left this Shrine open so easily. Maybe I should have had the Rod Eater protect, considering it has a massive countdown. I don't know. But considering I can get a Cleaver next turn or an Arbalester, I should be fine. I think I pulled ahead in this match the last like 2 turns. Welp, he just wasted a Mirror Shambler. And I will go for more order and play a Cleaver, and it does have Dominion, so it is huge. I could damage the State Machine. I think it's wiser just to hit the idol because I can finish it off with that. And I'll play the cleaver down here. And I don't have enough to pump. Oh no, I do have enough to pump once. Okay, so I can have the Psalm Giant next turn and attack next turn. And I can play an Arbalester. A tier 3 Arbalester. I get a lot of gold from playing Highlander because of the tier 3 scrolls. Blightseed plating. Well, let's get rid of the Iron Bile. Can't win this turn. Do we just make this thing attack? Nah, I'm gonna play the Arbalester. I'm gonna Earthbond you. Let's just play the Arbalester first. So now you have 3. And I can take down the Royal Banner, which I want to do. And I have the two Order 6 drops already. And I had the, I drew all the Order 6 drops. And I'll actually give you more attack. I mean, more health. And then I'll pump a little bit. And then I'll hide. Okay. Things are looking good. Next turn should be a win, considering all the stuff I have attacking. Solemn Giant, Wildling, and a Wings Cleaver. Yeah. So many strong units. It was a very lucky Highlander for me. Look at my board. You can kind of tell like by the amount of like strong creatures on the board, like Brave Rod Eater, Solemn Giant, Wildling, Arbalester, and Wingsleeper. And I guess you could even say State Machine are all like very good scrolls. And it's like 7 of the 9 things on my board. Usually you see like filled boards with like mediocre scrolls that nobody gets played. That nobody plays. Or 7-10. Heritage. Okay, but he's defending his idols a little bit. And how can I do this? Let's get rid of the Scout Auto. Vicious Strike. I can give something one extra attack. I have to play that before pumping. So how does that work? I can't win this turn. I don't think I can win this turn. Right? Even if I give you 8. Actually, yeah, I can win this. No, I can't, so then I can't play Snorkel after the Vicious Strike. So I can't win this turn. Maybe next turn. But yeah, I'm not gonna pump actually, I'm just gonna clear through. I'm gonna play the Tempest Reaver instead there. And kaboom. So now this turn, let's see what I can do. I have a spell to play with Vicious Strike. Yeah, that Ken Netta for him has survived this whole game so far. It survived, what, like 18 rounds? We're on round 20? I guess 17 rounds he played it on turn 3, I think. Maybe turn 4 or 5. But similarly to my Shrine survived a very long time. But I actually had the Meyer Shambler and the Skirmisher out before. Bear Paws. Let's get rid of the Snorkel. Iron Whip. Is that enough to win? Yeah, I think so. There's multiple ways I can win right here. Iron Whip would make you have 6, and then I pump. Oh no, I don't even win. I'm stupid. What am I doing? Well, lol. I don't know, I'm not really thinking right now. Welp. Guess another turn to see if I could draw more tier 3s. I'm tired. Not playing well. Man, look how strong my creatures are. 5 attack, 5 attack, 7 attack, 5 attack, 8 attack. Let's see if I could win this turn. 'Cause that would be good. Okay, what does he do? Moves him out of the way. And oh, I can't use Vicious Strike and Tempest Reaver. It would cancel out the other. That's a little annoying. Faith duty. Faith duty. Well, that's gonna be GG. Because oh, fierce tactics. That's not GG though. This is GG. So this took a little while, but it was a fun match. So that's Ultimate Highlander for you guys. And I'll see you guys tomorrow with another video. I think I'll try to do the daily trials tomorrow and come out with the tutorial walkthrough for those with 4 hours left for them, probably. So thanks for watching. Like if you enjoyed, subscribe for more content like this. And just, I think, 2 days until Scrolls release, guys. Get pumped, and I'll see you guys tomorrow.